next bout of the evening is a semi-pro mixed martial arts bout to be held at the featherweight division and contested over 2 4-minute rounds. Making his way to the octagon, fighting out of the blue corner, representing Impact MMA out of Salisbury, please put your hands together for Joe Taylor! His opponent this evening, making his way into the octagon, he fights out of the red corner, representing Surrey Kickboxing here in Surrey. Please put your hands together for Joe Miles!
Well, you can hear the crowd noise go up a real level, and that's for this young man in the red, Joe Miles from Surrey Kickboxing, his opponent Joe Taylor from Impact. But a real pop there when Joe Miles entered the cage.
Yeah, it certainly was, Malcolm. A lot of crowd support here for this young man. That's only going to help buoy him up as we go into this first round here.
And a slight height advantage as well for Miles in that red corner.
You immediately see him opening up with the kicks, but closing the range nicely. Left himself open for the body lock, though.
Yes, Taylor, very quick and slick there. Obviously, there was a clue in the title there, Surrey Kickboxing, so maybe thought Miles, good upright fighter. Let's see what he's got on the ground.
Yeah, Miles has done a good job of retaining his guard there. He's looking to tie his opponent up. Perhaps he's looking for a stand-up from the referee. He's got a very tight, closed guard, but working higher here with the legs, trying to be very offensive.
Well, we were mentioning this between fights, the fact that in the old days, that was what a good stand-up fighter used to do, just try and tie his man up, hold him there until the referee stood you up. But the game is evolving so quickly, isn't it?
Yeah, it certainly is. You can't get away with just one discipline anymore. You've got to have it from everywhere, and he's looking for the triangle or the armbar. He's getting his hips off, breaking those angles, but squaring off again is Taylor, doing a good job of keeping those center lines straight. Anytime though, Malcolm, you see the hips higher than the head, it's not necessarily the best posture from which to advance, and I'd be very worried about that right arm at this stage.
Well, I was just about to say that, because it was Taylor that initiated this takedown, but he hasn't really managed to maximise from that, has he?
Yeah, he hasn't got a chance to get into a really good offensive posture with which to attack. Taylor's doing a great job of tying up with that right overhook and really using those long legs to try and control the range of engagement.
And finally they stood up. So although it was Taylor that took them down, you were very impressed with the way Miles dealt with that.
Yeah, I certainly was. He showed a lot of composure. He was the one really instigating a lot of the work on the ground.
And yet it's Taylor again going for that takedown. And as we saw last time, he was actually the one in trouble. So it seems going to be a hard night's work for Taylor, because obviously he's worried about the upright ability of Miles, but he hasn't managed to maximise anything once he's got his man down.
Yeah, he certainly didn't seem particularly comfortable when he ended up in that guard position. You know, wasn't able to sit back on his hips, get the head on the chest, control those biceps. Perhaps he's just looking for that dominant position, which is certainly easier said than done.
Miles has looked very comfortable. You almost feel like him saying, well, let him take you to ground again. You actually benefited from that last time.
Yeah, slightly different ball game when you are pressed up against the cage, though. It can often impinge a lot of the movement and it really dictate which way you can attack your submissions.
But if we look at this first round overall, Taylor Now he's got his man back down. Really has to work more efficiently this time, hasn't he?
Yeah, he's got to start showing the judges he has that intention to progress. He has that intention to land damage. Because whilst takedowns are great and they show where you want to control the fight, you've got to use them effectively once you're down there.
And again, Miles defending very well.
Yeah, he's extending his legs away, trying to create as much space as possible. And I'm really not a fan of the way that Taylor's holding around Miles' head with his right arm. It's putting it in a lot of unnecessary danger at this stage.
What would you prefer to see Taylor do? Because this is twice he's had the takedown opportunity and really came away with nothing. What does he need to do? What does he need to think about more?
I'd like to see him really sit back, sit down in the guard, put the head on the chest, hands on the bicep, really pinch in the elbows to close the hips down, and then he can start dictating, right, am I going to throw to the head? Am I going to throw to the body? Am I going to stand up and land my ground and pound? He has a lot more options.
Because they've been stood up once again, so he's taken his man down twice and got nothing to show for it. But it does make it just that little bit more complex maybe in the scoring.
Yeah, it certainly does. I mean, at the same time, he hasn't been under too much duress when he's been down there. He hasn't had to defend too many submissions. He hasn't really ever been off balance from the sweeps. So those takedowns are going to be the significant scoring factors in this round.
So we do come to the end of a very tight opening round. And Joe Taylor, he did get the takedowns. But Joe Miles here, the kickboxer from Surrey Kickboxing, defended so well.
Yeah, I have to wonder, Malcolm, is there a bit of damage possibly to the ankle of Miles? We can see him a little unsteady in his corner. His team have gone to work on the ankle, and they are very heavily taped.
He did do the two low kicks as well in those exchanges, and if you hit a bone wrong or the wrong angle, it can be damaging. So, Joshua, at the end of round one, we saw a slight change in tactic from Joe Taylor. The last 20 seconds, he was happy to stand and trade. Do you see that significant for the opening here of the second? Because again, he looks like he's looking for the takedowns, but he is ready to trade again.
Yeah, he looks like he's starting to get a bit more confidence on the feet, and he thinks perhaps he can get the better of his opponent here as he really changes inside, starts throwing those wide hooks, and he's earned a very easy takedown here.
Well, that's, again, the opening of the second, very similar to the opening of the first, with Miles on his back, Taylor there having the successful takedown. But this is what we were saying at the first round. You really need to see him work far more efficiently when he's there now, don't we?
Yes, we certainly do. It's just a lack of correct posture in this position. The hips higher than the head put you a little bit off balance, and it does put your head and your arms unnecessarily in danger. Looking to step the knee through for the pass now, though.
So as we look at the first round overall, as we mentioned, the key things being the takedown, do you have Taylor, especially with what he's doing now as well, ahead?
Yes, I certainly do. On the scorecards, I think the only significant factors in that first round were those two takedowns. Yes, there wasn't a great deal of damage caused once they were on the ground, but at the same time, Miles didn't offer too much in the way of offense, so you've got to go with Taylor in that first.
And Miles, as we said, we mentioned the good defense, but he's having problems here again now. He's got to turn this around, hasn't he?
He has, and the problem he's got is he's been stacked very tightly up against the cage, having your head compressed. Once your spine is out of alignment and you haven't got that straight back anymore, it becomes very difficult to start getting any movement in your hips. And, of course, on the ground, that's where all the magic happens.
Well, the only advantage for him, if there is any advantage to this, is it's right in his own corner. What will they be saying to him? They'll see this position. They'll know the danger. What will they be shouting into his ear there?
They'll be saying to him, you've got to try and, again, use your legs to extend the range, and you've got to try and get back to your feet here. He needs to be looking to plant a foot, plant an elbow, and just work his way up that cage, because at this point, he's just stagnating.
Yes, the fight is running away from him, really, in that respect, because we've been impressed with his defense, but we haven't been able to add any offense to that, have we?
No, I mean, that right arm of Taylor is in a lot of danger. If Miles could really see it, try and spin off to the side and, you know, at least make an attempt at getting hold of it, because the way Taylor is leaving it hanging out there, it's really just begging to be taken off him.
Now, if you were in Taylor's corner, would you be frustrated that the referee has forced them to come up again? Does it say that, you haven't maximised the opportunity?
Yes, I mean, he might be frustrated, but again, it's the right decision from the referee. And we can see straight away, again, he's in for a takedown. And whilst, you know, there may not be too much happening when they're down there, it's winning him this fight right now.
So really, what you're saying is he's grinding out a decision here.
Yeah, it's really just a war of attrition. Both these guys don't appear as though they're going to do too much significant at this point, and it's just going to be who can grind it out.
So Joe Miles has spent most of his time on his back. Well, we think he doesn't really want to be.
Yeah, we can see he had half guard for a moment, turned onto the wrong hip. You want to try and turn into your opponent, really get on your side. And unfortunately, he went flat-backed and he's given up what was a very easy pass for Taylor.
Yes, Taylor's done the right thing. You've just been a bit wary of his choices once he's got where he wants to be.
Yes, and now he's here. We can see he's stuck in a mid-mount at the moment. He either wants to choose to go very high and attack the arms and the neck or really sink his hips low, grapevine the legs, and start driving his hips into his opponent and just pinning him down.
But the bottom line is the longer he's there in that position, the more chances are this is going to be a big win for Taylor, because Miles has not had a chance really to show any offensive strategy.
Yeah, I think that's a fair comment. There isn't really too much of a decision in my eyes for the judges to make here. It's got to be two rounds to Taylor. Yes, it wasn't pretty, but it was the takedowns and it was the control.
Ladies and gentlemen, a big round of applause for both fighters. We've gone the full 2 4-minute rounds, and based on judges' decision, it is a unanimous decision in favor of the blue corner. Please put your hands together for Joe Taylor! And a big round of applause for Joe Miles.